Guys, Rainbow Guppy here, and I'm just gonna do a video about me remaking this game that I love, that I made when I was in college. The only reason is I can't continue working on it is because it's in Game Maker 2, and Game Maker 2 is quite expensive now, which I cannot afford, so I am essentially rebuilding it in an earlier version, Game Maker 1.4, which I do own permanently, so it'll be a lot easier for me to work on it and to finish it, essentially, if it's in Game Maker 1.4, but it's not backwards compatible, so I have to essentially rebuild the entire thing, which is okay, I guess. I really like this game, and it's worth it, so. Okay, so what, my game is called Red Rover, and it's essentially based off of Animal Crossing, so you are this little character. And I think in my game, in my version, you are a goat person. And there's a simple tutorial set up at the beginning, but I'll be changing that probably later on. And so, you can, after doing the tutorial, you're free to go outside. And you can, so far in the game, there's two things that you can do. Okay, three things you can do. There's quite a bit of things you can do, but it's nothing compared to Animal Crossing. Anyway, there is a simple dialogue system set up for the characters, for the villagers. There is a way so you can pick weeds out of your town, and there is a way to pick up a shovel, and you can dig up things like coins. There's only coins right now, but, you know, it'll go from there. And you can water flowers. I don't know if in this version you can dig up the flowers, but that was something that I was working on. I did have a version where I was quite far on the code, where you could go fishing, and you could dig up flowers and replant them. And there was a couple other things you can do, but I can't remember them at the top of my head right now. So, right now is what I'm doing is I was trying to get the hang of using Game Maker again because it's been a while and this was like a thing that I've been wanting to do for a while, but I haven't had really the motivation to do it. But now that I have a little bit more extra time, I was finding it myself able to be able to work on it. So right now, essentially what I'm doing is I'm copying the tile sheets from the Game Maker 2 version and pasting them into Game Maker 1.4. That way I can use the tile sheets of the characters, because these are the animations for the characters. So I can use them in 1.4, and I use these as a base for all the animations for the characters, so I can just copy one of the little sprites on the sprite sheet and paste it into its own sprite, so that way I can set up all the animations for all the characters. So this is essentially just a base. And let's see. Yeah, see, I'm opening the files to see, and I renamed them 1, 0 through 3 because in Game Maker it's set up so the numbers start at 0 and go up from there instead of starting at 1. It's just easier as a coder. I'm basically a coder, so it's easier for me to understand to put them in order from 0 to 3 instead of 1 to 4. It helps me keep track of the number of sprites in an animation and all that. So right now I'm cutting the goat sprite out of the sprite sheet, and I'm pasting it into its own sprite. So I'm essentially setting up the first animation for this game. And let's see. I'm looking for the next sprite, I think, for the goat. Oh, and it's very important to make sure that I name the sprites a certain way, so that way I know how they're set up and everything. But this first video will be pretty slow because I was still trying to get the hang of using GameMaker again because I haven't used it in a while. But so there are some a little bit of, you know, window hopping to try to figure out how it works and everything, but I do get it eventually. So right now I'm just looking at the different sprites and trying to figure out how to set them all up. Because I haven't used GameMaker 1.4 in a while, since I was working in GameMaker 2 last time. So it's a little bit different. The code will be easier to transfer from 1.4 to 2. But setting up all the sprites is what takes up the most time. So here I'm setting up the sprite so it's in a certain spot on the sheet, because if the sprites aren't lined up in a certain way, then the animation will look jumpy. So that's what I'm doing here. And I figured out I can just copy the current one I have and paste it in there. So now I'm looking for the next sprite for the animation. And 1.4 is kind of annoying because you have to close certain windows in order to get access to different windows, so it's really frustrating, but it's a lot easier to work with than, you know, something like Unity, which I do Unity, but GameMaker is better for 2D games, which this is a 2D game, but it's not, like, fully 2D. It's a 2.5D, which means it's kind of like 2D as in the assets and the sprites are all 2D, but 3D as in the world will be 3D, so it's kind of set up like you can walk behind trees and in front of trees, and you'll be able to walk behind houses and in front of houses without, like, you know, bumping into the back of the house or something. So it's kind of like the old school versions of Pokemon, but you can actually go behind the houses and behind the trees instead of, you know, bumping into the top of the tree, which is essentially just making a big old box around the sprite. So I'm going to set it up differently than that, but other than that, it's really cool. And if you ever played Don't Starve, the animation or the gameplay will be kind of like Don't Starve. It's not like survival game, but it's set up like the animations are set up. So it's really cool. I was just really proud of myself when I made this game. Even though I didn't really set up a lot of things to do in the game, I did get a lot accomplished, and I think I only worked on this game for 5 weeks, which is a surprisingly short amount of time for how much coding I did, but I did work on it 3 to 4 hours a day, and here I won't be able to work on it as much, but I'll still try, and I'll still make videos to record and show you guys what the process is of remaking a game in GameMaker 1.4. It's not going to be like a step-to-step tutorial, but you'll be able to see what I'm doing and how I'm doing it. So that way, if you wanted to follow along, then you could. But you'd have to find all your own sprites and all your own code, because I'm not going to leave any of that in the comments or in the description. But, you know, it's awesome to make games. I didn't realize that I liked to make games until after my friends and my family told me I was good at coding. So when I started playing with coding, I got really good at making games. And GameMaker was one of the first versions of game making I made. It was the first version of a game making software that I made. And I'm running out of video for now, so I will catch you later, and thanks for watching.